I'll start with a small prayer and at least the feeling of the prayer towards all the sentient beings who have happened in the past, who are right now present, and who will be happening in the future. I start with that. The ones who are trying to bring more harmony, more peace, more love, compassion to this world. My gratitude towards all of them. Like I mentioned, the series of this video talks is a result of an inspiration from my master or spiritual teacher or a friend who guided me into meditation, who many of them who have guided me into meditation over the last 25 years. One important thing I learned from them all is awareness. In fact, it's wrong to say I learned. They taught techniques to help align the body, clean the mind, empty the emotions, balance them, bring harmony at all levels. When everything was aligned, suddenly the awareness started revealing the other dimensions of joy, of bliss, the happiness and love. Unconscious we have lived and many of us live. When I say unconscious we live, or when Buddhas or enlightened ones say that we live unconsciously, it's simple as a meaning. That we are dependent for our joy, our happiness, our love outside of us. That is unconsciousness. Consciousness and awareness is, I am source of love, I am fountain of joy, I am happiness. That is conscious living. When I say this, definitely many of us don't feel like that. That I am joy, I am happiness, I am love. So is there a problem in what enlightened ones or realized ones or meditators are saying? Or are they lying? When they say they are joy, are they someone special? Over the 25 years of being with the monks, meditating with them, spending time with them, they also said, no, we are no special. We are same like you. We are little aware and conscious, and you are not very conscious. Many times it happened, I said, there was a very well-known monk was here, highly realized yogi. I bowed to him, I said, I bow to you. And he instantly bowed to me. I tried to touch his feet, he says, I touch your feet. And I was like, why are you doing that? He just did and he left. He didn't explain much. After 10 years, I realized that why he did that. He was trying to say the same joy, same love, same compassion. I am also made up of that. He is no special than me. I bow to him because I see something of a possibility of me in him. He bowed to me saying that I see you as no different than me. I and you are no different. I am no special, just little difference. Osho, I heard many times Osho Rajneesh, he used to say, only small difference. I have awakened and you are asleep. Is that even a difference to call? One is awake, one is asleep. But technically, we are the same. And in sleep, we dream, we blame, we complain. In awareness, in wakefulness, we see. We see, we fix, and we change. Ourselves, not the others. In sleep, we try to change others. We blame others. We complain for others. In wakefulness, we see ourselves and we change ourselves. It's a big difference in awakened ones and asleep ones. Awakened ones are focused on themselves and they want others also to be focused on themselves. Today we live other-centric life. Everybody teaches us, oh, care for others, care for poor people, care for parents, care for kids. You are not important. But that's a wrong way to live life. You are the most important faculty here. Care for yourself, love yourself, be kind to yourself, accept yourself. Today, the world is going through a lot of troubles, a lot of issues, because of many, many problems are created from individual unconsciousness and unawareness. And people who create guilt, create stress in the system are the ones who are trying to exploit the humanity. Then I would say there are categories of people who are always living in comparison and fear. There are priests, politicians, dogmatic religious belief systems. They are constantly worried about the numbers. Oh, I should have more followers. Oh, I should have more votes. Oh, I should have more attention. That is unconscious way of living. Be conscious, become aware. More is not always right. Just because you have 1,000 people saying, like in the past, if you go, there were millions of people thinking Earth is flat. That does not make Galileo as wrong. Galileo is right, Earth is sphere. Doesn't matter how many number of people say it is flat. Same way, as we as a humanity mature and grow, all these lies that are being taught to us are going to evaporate. Lies are being fed from very childhood in name of religion, in name of nationality, in name of culture, in name of identity crisis. Oh, if I don't speak this language, I will lose my identity. Oh, if I don't preserve, I will lose my culture. Anything that is not real, better disappear. Anything that is not scientific, better disappear. Because if, like Galileo at that time, poor guy was beaten with stones, just because he said Earth is spherical. And some book somewhere said, oh, it is not spherical, it is flat. And somebody interpreted that book that way. So people who live by book, they live by book, not by real life scenarios. We are human beings. We should live the life of awareness, consciousness. The situations are constantly changing. New research is constantly coming. Books were written by the people of the time, or for the people of the time, may have been written by the timeless experience of the person who realized. But a lot of things in those books and knowledge was time-bound. Some timeless things were there, which can be extrapolated and put in different bucket. So this is a timeless. What is timeless? Compassion, love, giving, kindness, becoming aware, becoming conscious, that is timeless. How you live, what you eat, when you sleep, what is right, what is wrong, it is all time bound. When people mature, time changes, intelligence changes, we need to step out. Just because something is very old does not mean it is right. Just because something is very new does not mean it is wrong or right. evaluate. One way of evaluation we have is this body, this mind, this emotion, is it getting sweeter every day? Is it getting compassionate every day? Is it becoming loving every day? Is it becoming happier every day? Is it becoming joyful? Simple way to evaluate. Joyful within, not from without, not because I am joy that is coming from, I am happy here, not because I am doing something, not because somebody is giving me something, not because I am harassing someone, no. Not because I am converting someone, not because I am trying to put my ideologies out there, no. Just sitting, am I joyful? 10 minutes a day sit, are you joyful or are you bunch of thoughts, confusions? If bunch of thoughts, confusions, stress, anxieties, worries, guilt, and lot of the other baggage we have, then we need to clean up the system so we can be joyful. Life is simple. Kids, you see, children, they are so happy. Why? Because luckily, fortunately, our societal conditionings have not corrupted them. They are innocent. They live spontaneously. Become like a child again. Become like a children again. Live life wondrously, joyfully. Forget about everything else. We are made to live joyfully, and it'll be amazing. This world can be heaven itself. There is no more heaven to look for up in the sky somewhere after death. This very life, this very planet is heavenly. We don't need to look for heaven somewhere else after death. Why we look for heaven after death is because we are unhappy here. And who have made you unhappy? Same people who are preaching that heaven is better have made you unhappy here. And they want you to be unhappy here, that way they can control you, they can exploit you. Same people who are trying to teach you that, oh, you should do good deeds, are trying to make us miserable. And that is unconsciousness that we are living in. So become aware, become conscious, become alive. And for that, there are techniques, and modern science will agree to those techniques. Psychotherapies are there. There is psychiatric systems, but other than that, there are techniques of meditation, there are techniques of sound, there are techniques of cleansing. Take part. Take your life in your control. You don't need anyone to help you out. Take the techniques, use them. It's like you have shower available at home, you are stinking and dirty, you don't need someone else to come and give you shower. Go in the shower, take it and be clean. Put some fragrance, smell good. you don't need someone to come and tell you that. Oh, don't worry, my water is better. Oh, my shower is better. My soap is better. Whichever fragrance you like, take it. Somehow clean. Clean so you can relax, rest, joy, enjoy and celebrate. I have learned many techniques. You can join me for the weekly programs online. You can join me in person. I have learned over 25 years and many schools of meditation, and I have visited all the places of worship, including mosques, including temples, including gurudwaras, including Buddhist monasteries. Everywhere I had churches, including churches, anywhere and everywhere I have had chance, I have visited. And I tell you, yes, everywhere and anywhere, including your home, in your office, you can be calm, peaceful, joyful. Instantly, if you are aware and conscious. That is all for today. And whenever you get chance, join us. More information will be shared about our website and events. Thank you.